Six Sigma and how Six Sigma is helpful for you, your customer and your boss, right? And to help you understand Six Sigma, I have picked up a product here. What is this product?
Milk, sir.
Very good. A bottle of milk, right? And a bottle of milk, when you buy any packed milk packet, you can understand there are certain specifications written. Can somebody tell me what are these specifications? These are nothing but?
Calories, protein, fat.
Very good. Calories, fiber, carbohydrate, protein, fat. These are nothing but CTQs, critical to quality characteristics. If you take care of all the CTQs, your customer satisfaction will be at its best. That means your product quality is great. If there are problems with respect to the CTQs, then customer satisfaction will get negatively impacted. As a result, quality is gone. So your ability to produce products with CTQs meeting the customer requirement. And now, to help you understand Six Sigma, I will take only one of the CTQ. What is this particular thing? CTQ, calories. What is written here? 137 calories. Every pack of milk have 137 calories. Since it is very difficult to maintain a single value, customer always gives tolerance. You see here, tolerance is written. 137 plus or minus 2. What is USL?
139
is USL, 135 is LSL. Target is 137. If you could produce milk bottles meeting, or no, all the milk bottles having the calories inside 135 and 139, your milk bottles considered no great quality. See here, there are 5 CTQs here. All 5 CTQs you must satisfy, but we are discussing only one, right? If every milk contains the calories with 135 and 139, that will be accepted. Visualize the specification limit. USL is here, LSL is here, target is here. What is this? This is the customer requirement. Customer requirement is visualized. Now, you are the quality head. You wanted to be sure that every milk bottle you produce contains calories within this range. Now, tell me, will you check each and every milk bottle we are producing in your plant?
No, sir. We need to take samples, batch.
You need to take samples. So imagine you have taken some sample, maybe a sample of 100 bottles you have taken, or maybe less. Okay, 100 bottles. That means with 100 sample, you have 100 data. Each data talks about calories. Now, what will you do with the 100 data? I want you to calculate average. Average is found to be 137. That means your process is properly centered. This is a healthy scenario because customer target is 137. Your process target is also 137. This is good. And now, what I want you to calculate next is standard deviation. Standard deviation is 0.66. And how is it helpful for me? Once I have average and standard deviation, I want you to calculate control limit. What is the formula for control limit, upper control limit? Average plus 3 sigma. Can somebody tell me what will be the value of 3 sigma when sigma is 0.66? Come on. Sigma is 0.66. How much is 3 sigma?
3
into 0.66. That is almost 2. So 137 is the average, 137 plus 2, 139. My upper control limit is 139, lower control limit is 135. All right. So control limits are visualized. Process width is visualized. I want to understand whether my process is capable or not. Capable means it will deliver output meeting customer requirement. So I am overlapping. I have overlapped. And now tell me, is that my process capable or not capable? Can somebody tell me looking at the picture?
Not capable, sir.
Is it not capable or is it just capable?
Just to borderly even.
Yes. It is the
anytime it go, it can go to out of control, control specific limit.
Very good, beautiful observation. But as of now, the control limit overlap with the specification limit, because control limit is also 139, specification limit also 139. If strictly speaking, the process is just capable. It occupied all the tolerances given by the customer. And now tell me, what percentage of points will lie inside your control limit? All of you slept. What percentage of points will lie inside control limit? 99.73% of the points always lie inside control limit. And these points are nothing but the samples. These samples came from the process. The process is what is producing milk bottles in your factory. So if you collect the samples correctly, whatever you observe in the sample will be observed in the population also. So 99.73% of the milk bottles you produce will lie inside specification limit, because control limit and specification limits are same. Now somebody tell me, what is 99.73% of 1000? Imagine you produce 1000 milk bottles every shift. Now what is 99.73% of 1000? You want my help? 99.73% of 1000 is 997. That means when you produce 1000 milk bottles,
we are going to
very good within this 99.73. This is the rule of normal distribution. So 997 milk bottles are accepted by the customer, because customer can tolerate up to this. Similarly here also up to this. But how much customer might reject? 3 milk bottles might get rejected. Are you happy with your business?
No, sir.
Why? Why you are not happy? This is a good business, yeah. 997 milk bottles you are able to build.
But, 3 are going out now. They can negative feedback can may come.
Right. Okay.
Because milk is essential product, na.
That means you are more concerned about the future of your company. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Not worried about today's problem. Today's problem is only 3 milk bottles. Each bottle is only 50 rupees. It is only 150 rupees. That's okay. But you are more concerned about the future. Now, customer will talk badly about me. And so I really wanted to improve. So I really appreciate your thinking. So it is in that long-term approach, this capability of 99.73 is not good enough today. Is not good enough. Definitely no. For a long-term success, your capability should be more than 99.73. And statistically, this process is called just capable process. And or you can call it a 3 sigma process. This process, you can call it 3 sigma process, because the distance between the center of the process and the specification limit. Can somebody tell me what is the distance between the center and the specification limit? How much is this distance equal to?
3 sigma.
Very good. And this process is called a 3 sigma process. And a 3 sigma process assures a result of 99.73%. But this result is applicable only for short term. Because in long term, what will happen? When you produce more, what will happen? The variation will automatically come into play. Variations can happen, for several reasons. The machine settings can change, the operators can change, or the ingredients quality can change. There are many things, can deviate. And as a result, the 99.73 will not be valid, for a long term. So in long term, what will happen? The variation increase. As the variation increase, And this process, before talking about variation, this process, I generally give a nickname called elephant process. Why elephant? Only to let you understand that you have put a big animal in a small room, right? This process completely occupies the customer tolerance. Never try to put a big animal in a small room. It will definitely break the walls and then try to come out. Same way, if you keep your control limits, touch the specification limit, it will definitely move further. You see here, your control limit always in a long term will move away by a distance equal to 1.5 sigma. If the control limit moves wider and the portion of the curve you see here in region will be rejected by your customer. You might think, here it is very small. But sometimes what happens when the control limit moves, your entire curve will also move. If your entire curve moves, you see here, a bigger portion of your outputs are getting rejected, near about 8 to 10%. Near about 8 to 10% of your products might get rejected, and it is not just 3 out of 1,000, it is nearly 10%. So this is the consequence a process can give in a long term if you fail to retain the control limit inside the specification limit. So what is required is higher capability. How can I improve my capability further? I will improve the capability further by reducing the process variation. Reducing process variation is nothing but reducing the standard deviation. Earlier, my standard deviation was 0.66, and now the standard deviation is reduced to 0.33. Now you recalculate the control limit. What is control limit? Center plus 3 sigma. Sigma is 0.3, 3 sigma will be 1. So center plus 3 sigma, 137 plus 3 sigma. That will be equal to
138.
Staying upper control limit here and similarly lower control limit here. And now this process is called doubly capable. Why it is doubly capable? You see here, customer tolerance is plus or minus 2 calories. But your process tolerance is only plus or minus 1 calorie. The tolerance is only half of the customer tolerance. So that's why I call this process doubly capable. And now what is the advantage I get? You see here.
Zero reduction.
Very good. See here, within this control limit, what percentage will lie? Our understanding is 99.73. If 99.73 can lie within control limit, then what can lie within specification limit? Because customer always studies with respect to the specification limit. I will say this will be much more than 99.73. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
That means it is very close to 100%. That means it is very close to 100%. That is why companies want higher sigma level. And this process is giving you results closer to 100%. So I will call this process a giraffe process. Why do I call it giraffe? You look at the graph. When I reduce the standard deviation, control limit is pushed inside. So the center will become taller. The shape of the process, you can understand your capability. So only to help you understand that the graph will grow taller in the center. When you reduce the standard deviation, I call it a giraffe process. And talking about the capability, sigma level. Now again, recalculate the distance between center and specification limit. How much is this distance? Can somebody tell me? This is equal to? How many sigmas are here? Do you see 6 sigmas here between the two? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So this process is called 6 sigma process. And now what is the advantage? This will give you a result of 99.999%. Now imagine you are producing, 1,000 milk bottles. And now tell me what is 99.999% of 1,000?
Close to 100.
Close to 1,000.
Very good.
Yes. Almost all the 1,000 will have calories between 135 and 139. That means everything you produce, customer will accept. And now something goes wrong. Because of some variation, something goes wrong. And something goes wrong, what happens? Your process will shift as usual. If the process shifts, generally it is estimated that the process will shift by an amount equal to 1.5 sigma. So my control limit will also shift by 1.5 sigma. Even after shifting the 1.5 sigma, you see only this much portion of my output are beyond the control limit, but still majority of them are inside the specification limit. Hope all of you agree, understand this. That means even after some additional variation, your process can still assure your result of 99.999% in a long term. So that is why higher capabilities helps in our business. So this is the success rate of a Six Sigma process, right? And see here, I write 8 to 10% here also, but this 8 to 10% are not visible to your customer. Am I correct? This is company practicing Six Sigma will consider this as a failure, but this is purely internal failure because still the specification limit is here only. Customer is still ready to buy this product also, but a company practicing Six Sigma will not send this kind of output to the market because they know this output is not up to the mark. And now we have come to the end. And now tell me, what is the kind of process you are seeing here in my slide? Is it an elephant or a giraffe?
Elephant.
Okay.
Elephant is.
Very good. And what is the sigma level here for this process?
Three sigma.
Very good. Three sigma. And what is the success rate of Three Sigma process?
99.73.
But please note, this 99.73 is only short-term success. In long-term, what will happen? The control limit will move, process will shift, and then no damages will be more.
Yes, sir.
And now this process, I improve. That means I push the control limit inside. And now tell me, is it an elephant or a giraffe?
Giraffe, sir.
Statistically, what is the sigma?
Six sigma.
99.99.
Very good. Six sigma success is 99.999. This 99.999, is it a short-term success or long-term success?
Long-term.
Long-term.
That means when there is a huge increase in demand or some variation happens within the factory, that will not affect your end result. That will not affect your customer experience. Customer experience is always better. Very good. So when standard deviation is too much, you can understand it is hard to produce output meeting customer requirement. Under such circumstances, sigma level will be low, yield low, TPMO will be high. On the other hand, when I reduce the standard deviation, process will look like this. That means virtually everything I produce will meet the customer requirement. Sigma level will be very high, in the order of 4.5 to 6. That means yield will be high and deep. So any problem when you are solving by Six Sigma, it is nothing but a real-time problem is converted into a number problem, that is statistical problem. And always for a number problem, a statistical solution exists. What is statistical solution? Reduce standard deviation. And then how do we reduce? By working in real time. If you work like this, every problem can be solved. And the results are definitely guaranteed when you approach this, when you follow this approach. But if you want to follow the other method, which are called the, trial and error method, solution is rare. Whereas here, frequently you get the success. Here, rarely you get the success. That's the main difference. So this approach can help your organization, generate more revenue because you are not producing any defects. You do everything right at the first time, and so revenue will get multiplied. Your cost will go down. There are no defects, there are no rework. So your operational cost, manufacturing cost will come down, and then it will improve the efficiency of your resources. Every resource is effectively utilized to produce more output. And most importantly, the people who are working in these kind of projects and companies, they will become very, very effective. Because if you equip the people, they will equip the organization, and then your organization will grow faster. And individually, this knowledge will be very, very helpful to all of you. This will directly impact your problem solving and then decision making skills. That means you will turn out to be a very good leader very soon. A leader know how to impact the business result and then how to impact the revenue in any company. And then that means you will be making yourself fit enough to work with premium brands, right? Maybe your dream company, You can work for your dream company as a consultant also, right? The moment you learn this methodology and then the tools and techniques properly. And that means learning Six Sigma will make you highly successful in your professional life as well as personal life. So Sigma level is a measure of process capability. Specification limits are provided by the customer and control limits are calculated using process data. A 3 Sigma process is just capable in which the short-term yield is 99.73. However, a 6 Sigma process is doubly capable in which the long-term yield is 99.99666%. Almost everything you produce, customer will happily buy. There are no rejections. And if at all there are rejections, that will be limited to 3.4 defects per million opportunities. In a 3 Sigma process, control limit will overlap with the specification limit. In a 6 Sigma process, control limit will be placed well inside the specification limit. Higher Sigma level means higher capability. If you want higher Sigma level, Sigma should be reduced. Problem solving and decision-making skills are much needed and very helpful, you know, for your success. So that's it from me on the white belt, and we already spoke